I'm on a call, see you on TV. Some sexy done changed ever since we was when I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Watch all of us at the house on vacation.
Hey! This right here, y'all know this is my song. This has been like my anthem. I've just been having so much positive things going on in my life. Welcome back, guys. I am back. Welcome to the Golden Goddess Universal Vlog. I am so sorry. That has been so long since I've uploaded. The last video I had was in January. It is now July. So, I promise going in the future, it's going to be like every week. I'm going to try my best to upload a new episode every week so I can build my videos and continue giving you guys what you guys like. It was just so much going on in the beginning of this year. It was just, this semester was a lot. And it was my senior year, so kudos to me. I graduated from Florida Memorial with my bachelor's in psychology with a minor in criminal justice. So I'm so proud that that milestone is over. You guys don't even know. Okay? Besides that, I also joined House Arrest 2 championship dance team at Florida Memorial. So yes, I'm number 61, boss lady. Yes, I made that happen. Okay? I also joined Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, the Delta Eta chapter. I am number 9, honey. So I just had so much stuff doing. You know, I had to reach these accomplishments. So now I gotta give you guys what you guys been waiting for. So we're gonna start this segment with educate yourself. So since I attended a HBCU, a lot of people was asking me about my experience there and going forth and how they should kind of, well, the differences between going to HBCU and maybe a PWI. And it's just the little things here and there that you want to be cautious of, especially if you're a freshman going to college or if you're in high school and you're trying to make that decision. So for me, I always try to tell people to, they really want to try to find out what teaching method works for them. If you check out one of my previous videos, you will definitely see that I give a checklist of some things that you also need to pay attention to that people don't tell you before you go to college. But you definitely want to try to find out what's your learning style and adapt to that. I'm a person that went to HBCU and I also went to, I wouldn't technically call it a PWI. I went to FIU, so that's Florida International University as well. That's a very diverse school, more so international. A lot of people from different countries go there. And I also went to Southern Illinois University in Carbondale, so that school is very diverse. They have a lot of black people, a lot of Hispanics, a lot of white people. Not so many international, but it's also a very diverse school. Excuse me. I always tell people that it's such a big difference because when I went to SIUC, the classroom sizes was like 200 people. Like, you rarely knew your teacher. Like, even going to their office hours, you would have somewhat of a better relationship to try to get to know them, but you were still kind of a number. But I would definitely say at SIUC, all of the teachers weren't there just for a paycheck. Now at FIU, in my opinion, most of them was there just for a paycheck. FIU was equal to the same size as SIUC, so it's at least 200 students or more in the classroom. Going to office hours mean nothing. So you really had to just be book smart. Most of the things were book smart. It wasn't you really didn't learn as much where it's more so hands-on experience. So that's definitely something that you want to make sure that you pay attention to when you're looking at universities and deciding if you want to go to HBCU. going to HBCU, in most cases, most of the class sizes are smaller. You will be able to go to your teacher's office hours. You will be able to build that relationship with your professors and even possibly network with your professors. Like, since I graduated, one of my professors got me an interview. I didn't decide to take the position, but you just never know. Your professors are the plug. Like, they are the key. Like, you just really gotta keep them in your pocket. Network, check on them, make sure that they okay. And trust me, your professors know the teachers that's gonna make it somewhere and wanna do something to make a difference in their life and make a difference in other people's lives. So just be cautious of that. Going to an HBCU definitely make you more aware of your culture. You know, going to these other schools, like I said, it's really based on if you're book smart. It's not really based on if you know how to apply it on a day-to-day basis. And at HBCUs, they make sure that you know your information front and back. I know a lot of people that go to HBCUs are probably like, man, the work be easy. Some people think it's hard. Some people think the teachers be tripping. But the teachers definitely, like, structure their classes in a way to make sure that once you leave, like, the same things that they were telling you in the classroom, you'd be like, dang, I remember this teacher was saying this. Like, I didn't think this was gonna happen in the real world. And that matters, because in most cases when people go to school, a lot of students aren't working. Some are. Some people don't even understand how the real world would just slap them in the face. So you definitely just want to be cautious of that. Word of advice for anybody that go to HBCUs or go to school, period, network with your teachers. Ask questions. Bug them as much as you want to. If you don't understand something, you can ask a million and one questions, because guess what? They are getting paid for it. I had a teacher where she would get upset when people asked her questions, and it's like, I'm paying you. You're feeding your family because I'm sitting in this classroom. So at the end of the day, you're going to do your job, or I'm going to go above you. And I think that's one thing that you definitely get that inside at HBCUs, for sure. If you have an issue, they will go above your head and go to the next person. It's a little bit tougher to do that when you're at in a different school setting. But don't be afraid to go to the dean or go to the chairman or anything like that. Like, you're paying for this. Get your money's worth, because you're going to have to pay them back regardless. Pass or fail that class, you still have to pay them. So get your money's worth. I would definitely say it's been so transitioning into a adulting, I guess I should say. Well, for me personally, I already have been living by myself for years. I already was an adult. But it's completely different when you graduate college. Like, the things that they don't tell you is that, honestly, and I think I mentioned this in a previous video, you guys want to make sure that when you're in your senior year, I would say in the beginning of that last semester, if not before, start job hunting. Start job hunting. Stalk these employers. Yes, I said stalk. Call them. Ask for internships. Pop up and check the status of applications. Let them know that you're graduating in 3 months. You want to know if you can get a position there, how much they're offering, can you get some extra training, what type of certificates that they want, because the typical time frame for college graduates to get a job after graduation is anywhere from 3 to 6 months, me included. And I have a pretty solid resume. I'll just say that I have a pretty solid resume, and I have not decided on a position, and that's for a number of reasons. One being that I graduated with a bachelor's in psychology, so one just being simply that a lot of the typical jobs that would only be required, where a bachelor's degree would only be required, they're now asking you to have 3 and 5 years of experience, or they want you to have several different certificates, and it's not really logical qualification that they're asking for, because, for example, it's kind of like, okay, if it's a entry-level case management job, why are you asking for 5 years of experience for a case management job? Case management is a position specifically for entry-level bachelor degree, whether it's psychology or social work, or any area in the social science area. They're asking for 5 years of experience. If you are a caseworker and you have 5 years of experience, you must only want to be a caseworker for the rest of your life. Like, being a caseworker or case management is an entry-level field. It's an entry-level job, whether that's part-time or full-time. That's just something where they kind of, it's a position where they throw you into the wolves and you sink or you swim. Period. So asking for that amount of experience is kind of absurd. So I knew that it was already going to be a tassel graduating, but I didn't expect it to be as hard, only because of the amount of different certificates. Like, I didn't even know it was this many, like, different certificates that people want. Like, they want basic life support, and that's nothing. That's a very simple class, but that's just stuff that it would have been easier for college graduates to know ahead of time. And even in the psychology field, like, if you study psychology, you can also do business management. So you can work in retail, you can work with hotels, you have various options. So it is a little bit different in psychology. So some people probably do want to work in human resources or be a manager at a hotel, and that's fine. I just want to make sure that I work in my field and that I'm able to help people. So I'm not just going to settle, and I'm not just going to agree to a $25,000 job. That's just not going to pay my bills. This is not happening. So do what's best for you, but definitely be more aware when you're in your junior, your senior year. Definitely start job hunting. Definitely start looking for, if you know it's a specific position that you want, like if you know you want to do case management, try to intern in doing case management fields, or try to get certificates for basic life support. Like, it's probably $75 to $80, but your certificate is valid for like a year. So then all you have to do is worry about renewing. You definitely want to be proactive when it comes to job hunting. Okay? Okay, so I have this segment called Key to My Soul. So in the Key to My Soul segment, I'll allow people to ask me any type of relationship questions. So be mindful that next week, don't forget, you can also send me questions. I love when people give me questions. All questions probably won't be answered in one episode, depending on how many questions, but I will try my very, very best. Okay, so the first question I got, is it ever okay to cheat? So in my opinion, I don't think that it's ever okay to cheat. And I say that because if you're cheating, you're obviously unhappy. Number one, it depends on the seriousness of the relationship. Now, some people feel like they can date multiple people and have sex with multiple people, and if that works for you, then that works for you. I don't suggest it. But if you're in a committed relationship, there's no need for cheating. If you're unhappy, you need to discuss that and say why. Why cheat? Like, if you're not happy, let that be known. You don't have to cheat if you're not happy. Just leave. Say you don't want to deal with it. You don't have to cheat. Like, I feel like a lot of drama can be minimized. And I'm not just going to cheat. Now, some people also allow their significant other to cheat and then take them back. And then some people want to cheat back just because they cheated. Don't do that. I don't agree with that. If your significant other cheated and you decided to take them back, but you want to get revenge to cheat, you should never just took them back in the first place. You should just say, look, you cheated. That's one of my deal breakers. I don't think that this is for us, because obviously I'm not what you want, or obviously you can't fight your temptation. Because let's be honest, everybody has temptation. Men and women go through temptation on a daily basis. So if you're not happy, don't cheat. Just leave. Like, I'm not finna just cheat. Bye, deuces. That's very pointless to me. I feel like that's just... I just don't understand why people do it. Like, and I'm not going to say that I never cheated before, because when I was young, I admit, when I was young, yes, I had an ex. He cheated on me and I cheated on him, and it is what it is. But I was super young. Like, I wasn't even legal to drink. So, yeah. But now that I'm older and I'm wiser, like, now, like, no, I would never cheat. Like, if I just feel unhappy, I'm just going to let you know that I'm unhappy. I'm going to give you that time frame to work on yourself and to grow so that you can make me happy. And if you continue to not do that, then we'll just call it quits. And then I can just be doing whatever I want to. I could have sex with whoever I want to in the world. I don't have to cheat to do that, because nobody is forcing you to be in a relationship. Okay, so the second question was, why when females get in a relationship, they start dressing like grandmas? Why do they start dressing like grandmas in the bed with bonnets and with big old drawers? Where's the lingerie? Oh my God. Okay, so I have heard this a few times. For some reason, guys have a big issue with girls sleeping with bonnets on. I'm not gonna lie, I sleep with my bonnet on. I do. Do I do it every night? No. But I do sleep with my bonnet on sometimes. And I don't feel like it should be an issue with it. Now, most women, regardless of if they wear weave or natural, because I'm natural right now, but I also wear weave. I would throw on a wig in a heartbeat. But the purpose of a bonnet is to protect your woman's hair. Your girl, whether she's your woman, your girlfriend, your boo, your babe, whatever. The purpose is to protect her hair. So unless you want to invest in some silk or some satin pillowcases, which are very expensive, by the way, versus a little $5 or $10 bonnet, then you let this girl wear her bonnet. And I feel like sometimes guys are very unrealistic when they don't want girls to wear bonnets. Okay, it's like, if she can't wear a bonnet, but can she wear a scarf? Because let's be real, since we're being honest, guys used to wear do-rags to get their little waves up in their head and everything. And those things were never fine. Like, no guy ever looked good with a do-rag. Like, we probably hyped y'all up. It was like, oh, babe, you look good with your do-rag. I see your waves coming in. But, baby, that do-rag was never popping. Just like those Jabot pants was never popping. Like, it was never popping. It's just what was in style at the time. But it wasn't popping. So, I feel like that's something that can be compromised with. Like, don't be tripping because your girl going to bed with a bonnet on. Now, if you, at least, I can understand if she just walk around the house all day long with a bonnet on, then you tell her, like, okay, babe, go do your hair, take that damn bonnet off. But if y'all about to go to bed, like, let her put her bonnet on, unless you want to invest in some silk pillowcases. Or at least let her put a scarf down her edges, because you know girls got to lay down their baby hairs. Like, it don't matter if you black, white, Hispanic. It don't matter. Every girl got to lay down their baby edges. And you don't want her out here looking like anything, whether they natural or not. And it's way healthier for their health. Now, you also got to realize, now, maybe if your girl bald head, then maybe it don't matter. Now, I don't even understand why she got to have on a bonnet. But if she got some hair, then let her wear her little bonnet. Now, when it comes to wearing the big drawers, now, this is where you need to talk to your girl. I'm sorry, guys. You need to, that's a topic of discussion. Because once you're in a relationship, you do still have to keep that spice. Like, you can't be wearing big drawers all the time. Now, maybe if it's the, you know, menstrual cycle time, then yeah, every girl have period panties. Every girl wear the big drawers when it's that time, because they just want to be comfortable. Now, technically speaking, you're not really supposed to wear underwear as much, because it's healthier for your hoo-ha area. You know, you're supposed, at night, you're supposed to let it breathe. I was always raised that you're supposed to let it breathe. And you're supposed to always wear cotton underwear. Now, I understand when it's to certain occasions, you want to really get fancy, wear your little lingerie, which is fine. But you need to tell her to, look, babe, I know you look good at anything, but hey, why you always gotta wear these big old grandma jaws to bed every day? And I guarantee you, she gonna laugh and she gonna be like, okay, well, take me, let's go to Victoria's Secret, and you can pick out something that you like. It's gonna be real simple. Like, no girl, their feelings not gonna get hurt if you tell them somebody has some big draws. But at the same time, you need to ask your girl, why is it that she wear them? Like, is it just a preference for comfort? Because if it's for comfort, then maybe you could just tell her, maybe you could just get her to, you know, stop wearing draws to bed altogether. I'm just saying, it is the healthier way to go. And if it's not because of comfort, then maybe she has some personal insecurities. And then maybe you as her man need to be there to back her up, to let her know, look, babe, like, you beautiful. Like, I don't care about your booty dimples, none of that. And then maybe it's something that you need to do on your part because she doesn't have that confidence. So, it's a million different reasons why girls wear big draws. But don't just assume because she wear big draws, like, it's just because she got comfortable. But I will say, fellas, I do agree, some women do get too comfortable and they just think that they could wear those granny panties all the time, and I'm just not an advocate for that. Like, I'm very big on, okay, you start a relationship or you're dating someone, you have to keep them interested in you. Like, they didn't marry no grandma, so don't be coming with no grandma panties all the time. When he hit it the first time, he wouldn't have no grandma panties, did you? That's what I thought. So, you know, every once in a while. Now, if they wear granny panties once a week, like, gosh, you just gotta deal with that, because sometimes y'all drawers probably got holes in it or something, or got stains in it. So y'all probably don't even know how to wash your own damn drawers. Just saying. Not saying that's everybody, but I'm just being fair. Okay. So, guys, so now we're going to move to the next segment called Pick My Brain. So in the Pick My Brain segment, people can ask me any type of question that they just want to know, and I respond. So this is also a segment where you guys can send me questions through my social media, okay? So this question, oh Lord, what do you think your purpose is in life? Have you obtained this purpose? If not, do you think you ever will? This is one of the best questions that I received, like, in a very, very, very long time. Like, a very long time. This is a tough question. I think my purpose in life would be to definitely encourage others and be able to give back. Like, I think I'm meant to be an advocate for people who can't advocate for themselves. And I do think that, I think I'm on the right path to obtaining and fulfilling my purpose in life. I still feel like I have a lot of areas I can grow in, but I definitely know that I'm on the right path. I'm the type of person that want to make sure that I'm there to encourage others and inform them, help educate them, be there for them, be an ear to listen, be non-judgmental. And I feel like that's a lot of people don't get that. I'm a person that people can honestly be able to come to and know that I'm not going to judge them. I'm just going to, and if they ask for the advice, then I'll give them the advice. And I can just be very transparent. So I definitely feel like I am beginning to fulfill my purpose in life. And I don't care if it's just for boys or girls or women. That's why I'm a person that's very big on making sure that I'm relatable to all different type of people. I feel like being transparent and also being real-rounded is very important growing as a person, because if you can't relate to anybody, then what are you doing in life? So I try to make sure that I can actually relate to everybody in some way, shape, or form. I think I could continue by doing so by doing things that I'm doing now. Like, I'm the oldest of my generation. So out of all my brothers and sisters and all of my cousins, I'm the oldest. So everyone look up to me for, advice or the things that I do. Like, I'm the one that have to set the bar up high. And so it's very interesting, because it's like, since I'm the oldest, I have so many people that's depending on me. and people that I don't even know that's dependent on me and watching me. And so that's why I say you really have to be cautious of your character and how you carry yourself, because people tell me all the time, like, if they even just from a typical conversation, how much I make a difference in their life, or how they're watching what I'm doing, and, you know, or their child or their daughter or their son, you know, they see what I'm doing and they admire that. So I have to be cautious that I'm not just doing what I'm doing for myself, but I'm also doing it for other people, because who knows, I might have to be an advocate for somebody who can't do it themselves. Like, when it comes to my little cousins, my brothers, my sisters, since I'm the oldest, I'm always the advocate for them. When it comes to children of Chicago, I will always be an advocate for them. I want to be that person, that voice of reason, that can always help people tell their story and also be able to tell my story. So I feel like as long as I'm, right now, in some way, shape, or form, I'm educating people on how to improve themselves and how to be better people. So I feel like as long as I continue to do that, and I get to the point of even expanding my platform in order to do so, I will definitely be able to continue to fulfill my purpose in life. And ultimately, that's just helping people and giving back to my community, giving back to my family, my friends, helping educate, helping people in any type of way or form that I possibly could. And I know, just being another support system to someone else can do that, because you just never know what somebody else is going through, and you never know how you can affect that person. And honestly, a lot of the relationships that I have now with friends and sisters and people that's not even my blood, that I consider my blood family, like, we built that bond because of how I am. Me just being open, me allowing, you know, them to grow, and us helping each other grow, and me helping them see a different mindset of the world, because you gotta realize that everybody aren't raised the same. I was not raised the same way as someone else, and vice versa. So the more you educate them and let people know, the more that they will take that into accountability, and then that will also help them grow. And that's all I'm about, like, self-growth and helping other people. And so, yeah, I'm definitely going to continue to do that. Like, nothing will stop me from doing that. So, yeah. Okay, guys, so that gives it a wrap for this episode. You guys, don't forget, like this video, like, subscribe. Oh my god, I keep getting tongue twisted. Like, subscribe, and share. Like, subscribe, and share. Please, 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 write down below. Don't forget, you can also send in your questions for the Key to My Soul segment, as well as the Pick My Brain segment. The easiest way to do that, I will drop the information down below as well. Just hit me up and follow me on Instagram or Snapchat at Shanti717. That's Shanti with the S. Not a C, Shanti717, or also just shoot me an email at clark.shantiera@gmail.com, and just put in the subject line GGU blog, okay, so that I know that you're specifically asking for the blog. Okay, guys, I will see you guys next week. Again, I'm going to try my very, 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 very best to start doing videos more frequently, and also having more guests, and continue the various topics, okay? So, you guys, enjoy your day. I hope you enjoyed this. Don't forget to leave comments, but most importantly, like, share, and subscribe, okay? Bye!